Hey, this is Asaf Shabavi from LickNRiff.com, and it's time for another viewer request. And in this video, we're going to learn a fingerstyle arrangement I've made especially for you guys and girls of Gary Moore's Parisienne Walkways. First, I'm going to play it for you so you can see and hear how it goes, and then we're going to break it down lick by lick, note by note, finger position by finger position, with tabs on the screen as usual. But first, I just want to thank the viewer who donated this for the community, for everyone's enjoyment. The viewer donated to LickNRiff and just asked if I could do Parisienne Walkways, and I love this song, so why not? Thank you very much, viewer. It goes like this. Okay, so you begin with this. Okay, it's that simple. That's the whole intro. You slide down from 7 on the A string. Okay, you play the note first, you let it ring, and then you slide. You don't slide right away, you don't do this. You let it ring, and then slide. Then you do the same thing on 7 on the E bass. Then you do the same thing with 3 on the E bass. So it's 7 on A, 7 on E, 3 on E. Okay, now if you call out the notes E, B, and G, you get an E minor chord arpeggio. Okay, so it's actually this, because you slide from G to an open E bass, so it's high E, B, G, E. Got it? You get an E minor chord arpeggio. Now, how we're going to learn this is very simple. The way we're going to learn this is by chord shapes. Okay, there's a melody, and then you change a chord shape. It's always melody, chord, melody, chord. And when you're not playing a melody, you're playing the chord. Now, the picking pattern for each chord in this arrangement is very simple. The rhythm is always 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Okay, and the easiest way to do this, is by playing this. Okay, this is 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. okay? Or 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, same thing. Just a different method of counting. The first beat is always the bass note, okay? Whether it's on A, on E, or on D, the strings, I mean. The bass always comes first. And usually, you pick the bass along with a melody note. And that way, you already have the bass note along with the end of a melody line, usually. Then, all you have to do is arpeggiate the chord. Okay, don't worry if this confuses you. We're gonna go over this tons of time throughout this lesson. I just want to show you the pattern before we start. You can arpeggiate the chords basically in any way you choose. The easiest way is to go up and down the guitar, as I just did. Strings 3, 2, 1, 2, 3. Okay, we already played the bass. So bass, 3, 2, 1, 2, 3. That's the easiest way. You don't always have the entire bar to pick, but whenever you're not playing a melody, you can play the rest of the picking pattern. Or you can create your own arpeggios. You can reverse this. You can do 1, 2, 3, 2, 1. You can do 3, 2, 3, 2, 1. You can do 3, 2, 3, 2, 3. Or 2, 3, 2, 3, 2. Or 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. Or even 1, 3, 2, 1, 3. Okay? You can even go crazy and go 1, 3, 2, 3, 1. Or 1, 3, 1, 3, 2. Doesn't really matter which picking pattern you employ, as long as it's in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Rhythm. As long as you keep the rhythm and feel the rhythm, you just pick the strings to that rhythm and you'll be fine. So you start with this. This is E minor with a high B note. It's just open strings, the second, third, and sixth strings open with seven on the E string, the high E string, the first string. So you have, okay, 7, 0, 0, and 0. That's E minor. So pick this. You can slide into it. Okay, and then you have time for the picking pattern. But let's review the melody that comes right after so we can place the picking pattern. So it's 5, 3, 2. So it's, okay? See, we had time between the melody notes. So we filled it with the picking pattern. Got it? That's usually the time you have. 2, 3, 1, 2. Okay, or 2, 3, 4, 5. And then 6 is this. So this is the counting pattern. You don't want to count. You want to feel the rhythm. If you start counting, you're just gonna confuse yourself. Try to hear it. Try to listen to the melody and hear the rhythm. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Got it? If you can feel that, you can play it. If you can feel the rhythm, you can play it with groove. It's better to just listen and make mistakes as you go along than to start technically and mechanically counting the beats. You're just gonna bore yourself and it's not gonna be as fun. So that's it about rhythm. Let's learn how to play this. Okay, that's the first melody. Then you do this. It's open E string, 3 on the B string, then A minor 7. For A minor 7, I pick strings 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay, now A minor 7 is A minor with an open G string. Okay, now why do I pick strings 2, 3, 4, and 5? Because the melody note is on the B string, so I just let it be the highest note. That's just my style. You can pick strings 1, 2, 3, and 5 if you want, but I like to pick strings 2, 3, 4, and 5. So it was this. Okay, again, you only have four notes because then you have to do this. Okay, and then you have the time for the entire picking pattern. You do 7 on the E string, then you bar the 5th fret on strings 1, 2, and 3 with the open A string. This is A minor now. Again, you pick the bass note with the E string, which is the melody note, or you can pick the entire chord. Okay? Again, your choice. You can pick the melody notes. Or you can pick the chords. Okay? You can strum the chords. You can pick them. Or you can pick the melody note. And then play the chord. You've got choices. You can alternate between these choices and create a more interesting arrangement than just pick all the chords or none of the chords. You can pick some of the chords. Okay, you've got a choice. Play it by ear. Let your musical taste and musical ear dictate what you're gonna play. Listen to your own playing and just have fun. Okay, there's no set way for you to play this. Okay, so you can slide into 7 again. You can also slide into notes, as I said before. So that's the first phrase. 7, which is E minor. 5, 3, 2. E, open E string. 3 on B, A minor, 7. 7, 5 on E, into A minor. Okay, this is the first phrase. I'm gonna play it slowly, try to listen, and distinguish between melody and picking pattern. Okay, didn't play it too well, so let's play it again. As you've noticed, what my fingers choose to do is add notes between melody notes as well. I just add the G string, like this. Don't know why I do it. It's just what my fingers want to play, so I just let them play it. Okay, experiment with your playing styles, and you might discover new ways to play this entirely. Okay, completely different than how I play it. Don't be afraid to experiment. The next chord is this. Okay, and then and then it's G. Okay, that's the next phrase. It's D7 to G. So this is actually, this is not D, it's D5. Pinky on 5 on E, then 3 on B, 2 on G. So 5, 3, 2. Okay, it's just like D with 5 instead of 2 on the E string. So you play that, okay, with the D bass, of course. This is a D chord, it's D5. And then, okay, 4 more notes because the melody is next. 3 on E, then D7, and then open E string. Okay, so it's 3, D7, open E string. Got it? 5, 3, D7, open E string. Then 3, 1 on the B string, then G. Now on G, again, the melody note is the open B string, so I play strings 2, 3, and 4 as the chord. Okay? That's what I play. You can play this. You can play the high G note on the E string if you want. But I wrote this in the tab. So, again, D5, D7, G, then this, 5-3 on the E string, back into G, and this time you do pick strings 1, 2, and 3, because this is the high melody note. I hope you're starting to see the pattern here. Wherever the melody note is, I pick the strings below it as the chord notes. Okay, that's just my style. Now, also, the picking pattern, the melody pattern, okay, the rhythm pattern for the melody is almost always exactly the same. Dum, da da dum. Da da dum, da dum, and then again, dum, da da dum, da da dum, da dum. Exactly the same rhythm pattern. So you have exactly the same time left to pick the chords. Okay, it's the rhythm pattern of this piece is very, very repetitive. So once you've got it down for one phrase, you've got it down for the whole composition. Okay, so let's play this. Okay, and then this is on C major 7. So our bass note is going to be C, 3 on the A string, and C major 7 has open strings 1, 2, and 3, and we're gonna just add the melody to it. So it's 0, 2 on the E string, then C major 7 with 3 on the E string. Okay, don't forget open second string, it's not C, it's C major 7. And we don't need the D string, so we can just put this on instead of the entire form. It's 0, 2, 3, that's the melody. And then 2, 0 on the E string. Then 3 on the B string. We're still on C major 7. Right? That's the melody. And then this, 1-0 on the B string, and then this. Okay, this is F sharp diminished. You bar the second fret entirely. You put your second finger on 3 on the A string, and you play the bass on E, and two on the G string. That's the melody. And then you just arpeggiate it. So, okay? That's basically it. Okay? This time you play strings 3, 4, 5, and 6. That's the chord. So it was this. Again, exact same picking pattern, exact same rhythm pattern for the melody. Okay, so I'm not gonna repeat the rhythm again. we're okay, because it's kind of pointless. We've gone over this. This lesson is going to be 2 hours long if I just keep repeating the rhythm. So I really hope you got it. If not, just rewind the video, start again, and practice. So, and then it's three on the E string. Then it's A minor 6, but you don't have to put this shape on. You can just put D7 on and play it with the A bass. Okay, it's the same chord, because it's a more economic way of putting this chord on. Okay, because if we just don't play the D string, we can put it like this. So you can put the D7 shape on, play it with the A bass, and that's your next chord. Okay, so this time you have the entire bar to fill. So you just play the chord at the beginning and arpeggiate it. So then you put on B7. But you can just take your first finger to 2 on the A string, because again, we don't need to play the D string. So that's a faster way to change. Okay, and that way the notes keep on ringing instead of cutting off. Okay, it's just a bass change and the notes go on playing instead of cutting off. Yeah, you see there was a stop there. And here there wasn't. Your choice, you can change into a full B7 shape or just move the first finger around. So, okay, that's the new melody. 2 on the E string. And then, it's open E string, 4 on B, then 1 on B, and I'd like to play the bass note again. This time I changed to this finger, to the second finger, so it was. Okay, just to keep some of the chord playing. So, 0, 4, 1, play the B bass again. Okay, and then you play, okay, let's play it again. So, B7, change, okay, change the shape. Then you play this, okay? Open B string, 2 on the G string, then E minor, and you play strings 3, 4, and 6. Okay? Or you can just play the third string and the sixth string. Or you can play strings 3, 4, 5, and 6. But in my opinion, that's a little bit too thick. So I like to keep the A string out of it and have a nice clean chord instead of too many notes. This is way too dark. This, strings 3, 4, and 6, in my opinion, sound a little bit better. Okay, so that's the first ending. Okay, we have two endings because we're gonna play it twice. So it was, and then, this again, and then, let's go over this. A minor. A minor 7, A minor, D5, D7, G, still G, C major 7, okay, and then remember this, F sharp diminished, A minor 6, shaped like D7 over A, B7, the second time around, instead of playing this, you play this. Four on the B string, and then E. Okay, now you play the entire chord and then arpeggiate it. Then you do the same thing for A, then E. That's the second ending. So the second ending goes like this. Let's start from this. Okay? Well, I said you should play the chord, and I didn't. I just played the E string along with the bass. I played this. But you can play the chord. Okay? So that's the first part of the arrangement. Alright, so let's go over it one more time with the second ending. So, 7, 5, 3, 2, E, 3 on B, A minor 7, 7, 5, which is A minor, 5 again, D5, D7, G, still G, wrong timing. Major 7, and then bar, B7, okay, I arpeggiated A differently this time. I started from the second string. You see, I just let my fingers play, and as long as I keep the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 rhythm, it sounds good. It doesn't matter how I arpeggiate the chord. That was what I was trying to tell you at first when we just started the lesson. So I hope that you got it by now. I really hope that you got the concept of just playing the strings, and as long as you keep the rhythm going, it's gonna sound good. Okay, as long as you put on the entire chord and just play around with the strings inside that chord. Okay, as long as you keep the timing, as long as the rhythm is correct, it's gonna sound good. It doesn't really matter how you arpeggiate the chord. That was what I was trying to tell you. So let's play this first part again, twice with both endings, a little slower so you can listen to it, really listen. And I'm gonna shut up. So, blacked out for a second. Sorry. And that's the first part of Parisienne Walkways, including the intro. It's really, really nice. I love this song. I love this composition. Gary Moore was an absolute genius. So, the second part starts like this, and then right? It's 4-5-7 on the E string. And then, with your pinky, 10 on the E string, and you prepare the chord. It's 8 on the B string and 9 on the G string. This is A7sus4. Okay, so you play 10 on the E string and then you play the chord. And then you bar 5 again. This is A minor again. And you add 8 on the E string. Okay? And you complete the bar. So 4-5-7, 10-10, 8-8. Okay? Okay, I was going for this, but that's not the chord. That's the first phrase. And then you play either D or D7, doesn't really matter. Okay, because the melody is 2-3-5, so you're gonna switch to D5 anyway. You can play D. And this time you start from the bass note, okay? You can play the chord. But I like to keep the melody note for when it's supposed to show up. So I play the bass first. You can play D7. Okay? Whenever I play it, I just alternate between D and D7. The first time around I play D, second time around D7, or not, or I'll play D7 and D7. Again, whatever your fingers want to play, whichever is more comfortable for you, whatever sounds more, suitable and sounds better to you, just go ahead and play it. You can play D7 or D, doesn't really matter. The melody is, it's on the E string. So, and then it's this. Okay? I think it's the biggest stretch by far. On LickNRiff ever, because usually I play this, okay, this G chord, 3 on the bass, 7 on E, and this time we'll play 8 on E, so it's 3 on the bass and 8 on E, and then we're gonna go to 7. So this is G, but the melody is, so 8, 8, 7-7. Can't help you there. You're just gonna have to find your own comfortable way of doing this uncomfortable chord. Just stretch your fingers. Sorry, that's how you do it. So, okay. And then a little bit of relief. It's... Okay, you play the bass again and then the chord, and then this is C major 7 again, by the way, just the bass, open 3 first strings, and you play it. Okay, and then the melody is 0-2-3 on the E string. Okay? Just like the D was this. It's the same pattern. Okay? Then it's this. Okay? It's seven, it's A minor again. 7-7 on E. You play the first 7 alone and then you play the chord. Then 5-5. Okay, now the second part has its own different, its own rhythm pattern for the melody. So I'll play everything up till now, and just try to listen to the rhythm of the melody. It's three notes, then you wait, then it's two notes, and then you wait again. It's da 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 da, and then again da 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 da. Okay, it's 3-2-2, and you have the chord between them. So that's the rhythm pattern here. And again, you arpeggiate the chord between them any way you like. You can also wait. I sometimes stop arpeggiating and just let the melody note ring. So we had this so far. 4-7, 4-5-7, 10-A-7-sus-4, 8-8 with A minor, D or D7, 2-3-5-8-8, G-7-7, C major 7. 0-2-3-7-7 with A minor, 5-5, still A minor, and then this. Okay, this is B7, okay, A7 shaped, bar on 2, and you play this. You play the entire chord, strings 5-4-3, and then the melody is the second string on 4. Then you lift the bar and put it back on again on E, because it's 0 and 2. On E, lift the bar, put it back on, keep the bass note ringing while you lift. Okay, keep pressing the bass note. So, and then this. Okay, 5-5-3-3. With E minor, just open strings, 1, 2, 3, and 6. So 5-5, E minor, 3-3, you can play the chord again. And then you play E minor, just stop. It's a break, because then we start the second time around, which is different. There's no first ending, second ending here. The first time around is played one way, the second time around is played slightly different. So, the first time around. Okay? And then. Then C major 7. And then. A minor with 7. Wow, worst confusion ever. And then B7, then 5 on E with E minor, then 3, and then you stop. So it was. E minor, break. Then you start the same way again. 4-5-7. 4-5-7 on E. Then you play 13, 12, and then A7-sus-4. So it's. Okay? Okay, so. And then this, 12, and back to A minor. So it's 12, 8, and you bar 5. Okay, so it's 12 with your pinky, and then back to 8 with your pinky, and bar 5, this is A minor again. So 13, 12, A7-sus-4, 12, A minor. And then the next chords, the D7, G, C major 7, and A minor, are the same way. You can do a variation here as well on G, if you dare. It's 8, 10, 7. Okay, if you want, you can do that. Okay, you don't have to. And then C major 7, A minor, and then this. This is actually a second ending, but we didn't play the same thing at the beginning, so it's not a first ending, second ending scenario, technically. So the next chord is this. It's 3-5 on the E string, and then this. This is G diminished. It's from the E string down, it's 6-5-6-5. Okay? 6 on E, 5 on B, 6 on G, 5 on D. Okay, so 3-5-6 along with the chord. Okay, G diminished, then it's this. 3 on the E string, then you bar for F sharp diminished again, and you play the bass with 2 on the E string as your melody, and you would arpeggiate. Okay, so it's... And then, three, zero on the E string, you can pull it off, okay, or pick it, doesn't really matter. Then, B7. This time you do want to put the entire chord on, including one on the D string, because we play this. This is B7, C7, B7. You just take B7 upper fret and back down to B7. And you arpeggiate it again any way you want, as long as you pick 2 on the first B7, that's the melody note, 2 on the E string, and then you can arpeggiate it however you want, as long as you don't pick the B string on the C7 chord. Why? Because when you take the chord up, you also have to take the B string from 0 to 1. And you don't have an extra finger for that. So, that's how it's gonna sound like if you play the B string. It's gonna be C7 major 7, and that's not a pretty chord to play during a very melodious piece. So, or there's another option. You can take your first finger, put it on 1 on the B string, but then you won't have this sound. Again, your choice. So, and then when you go back to B7, put it back here again. Again, your choice. You can do this and avoid the B string on C7, or B7, C7, put your first finger on 1 on the B string and avoid the D string this time, and then put it back on. I don't really like this sound, because, well, there are many reasons which have to do with harmonic theory, and it kind of doesn't belong in harmonically in the context of the song when you do this. Okay, because you have this and this intervals in there, and they don't really fit in with the rest of the harmony of the composition. But again, It's your choice. If this sounds good to you, then by all means, play it. Okay, the fact that I don't like it doesn't mean that you don't have to like it. So, that's the ending. It's, C7, B7, and then start again. So, let's play this from the top, the second part. C7, A minor, B7, E minor, stop, then again, 13, 12, A minor, then same thing. Or at 10, C major 7, same thing as before, A minor, then 3, 5, G diminished, 3, F sharp diminished, 3, 0, B7, C7, B7, stop. Start again. So let's play the second part slowly. Pay attention. Try again to distinguish between melody and arpeggios, forefront and back. So let's do this. Before you go practice this, please subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. I've got a ton of lessons on the channel already waiting for you, and you can go download the tab from the website for free. Everything is for free. The link is in the description. But if you want to give something back, there's a donation button on the website, and you're free to click it and give something back, whatever you choose to give. I'd be very grateful for it. It all goes right back into LickNRiff, into making these arrangements, into making the lessons, filming them, editing them, and, you know, it all takes time and effort. So if you want to help out, thank you very much. I thank you in advance for it. Go practice this. Go download the tab. Practice it slowly. Have fun with this. Create your own version of this. You don't have to play exactly what I play. Have fun with this. Be creative. And just, you know, make music. I'll see you the next lesson. Thank you very, very much for watching, and go have fun. Go get this under your fingers now. Bye for now.